What is Marvel's Avengers, and who is this game for? The short answer is a looter brawler structured identically to Destiny, with combat more akin to Batman Arkham games or Spider-Man PS4, for people who like Marvel Ultimate Alliance. The concise answer is the story mode will see you rebuilding the Helicarrier hub, an in-between mission home base that will remind most gamers of Destiny's tower. Fight, get XP, level up, find loot, equip gear, collect resources, bring the resources back to the Helicarrier, and 3D print better gear. A taste of an endgame experience for people willing to devote time to repeating missions and getting the best possible gear for the best possible loadouts. The long answer is Marvel's Avengers is a $60 loot-based beat-em-up, built to be enjoyed cooperatively with a group of up to 4, and depending on the game mode moving into the future, 6 players. The story mode will see the player controlling different Avengers as a light introduction to each hero, who is effectively a different class with distinct abilities that the gamer will need to learn the rhythm of to survive on the real difficulties. The beta showcases the primary abilities of the 4 heroes available to use, but there are also specialty and mastery abilities that are available in the full game to unlock the potential of some of these heroes. In the endgame, it's clear that teammate synergy will be necessary to instantly neutralize long-range attackers, stagger and destroy problematic foes immediately, or break the guard of multiple enemies who will otherwise quickly overwhelm with attacks that'll just keep interrupting your combos. Like a gun without its attachments, however, these heroes perform much worse without the right abilities unlocked. And like trying to snipe with a shotgun, unless you're playing the way that these heroes' kits dictate, players will have a bad time. Single hero story missions, strikes on strongholds, danger room style wave-based horde modes, and a campaign you can play either with AI companions or co-op with real people. Marvel's Avengers launches with 6 characters available to play at launch, but Crystal Dynamics promises to add additional heroes with missions specific to their story, at no additional cost, as DLC going forward will be free. Heroes like Hawkeye, Captain Marvel, She-Hulk, and Kate Bishop have already been discovered in the game's files and have a strong likelihood of appearing soon. But free DLC content moving forward means cosmetic microtransactions that, since we're dealing with a Marvel property, players will effortlessly fund by purchasing, if Crystal Dynamics delivers awesome, highly sought-after looks without shying away from some iconic outfits for their strongest heroes. Spider-Man PS4 wasn't afraid to show some skin, so I'm guessing we'll be okay. The build made available for everybody to play for the beta has a number of issues, chief among them being its inconsistent performance across all platforms. The PS4 Pro on a certain mode can handle pretty consistent 30 FPS, but OG PS4 and Xbox will chug, with frame rates dipping as low as 20 FPS during chaotic encounters. In interviews, the developers claim that the performance will be stable by launch, but with 2 more betas between now and release, players will have the ability for free to see for themselves. A secondary issue is a desperate need for a ping system to communicate to companion AI where they need to travel or concentrate fire. When I'm Hulk and focusing on what's immediately around me to finesse health while timing rage, having my combos interrupted by a sniper or long-range turret because my Black Widow and Iron Man are just standing there picking their noses, that shit sucks. If not a ping system, then perhaps better AI that will force Widowmaker to prioritize long-distance targets if she's not immediately in danger, or make Iron Man enter flight mode and kite some of that aggro around and give other people an opportunity to take out these targets. Performance issues, companion AI problems, absurd motion blur, screen shake, fighting with a camera that's auto-snapping to what it thinks is a cinematic angle, non-functioning matchmaking, and being kicked back to the main menu are many of the issues that I could list, but to be honest, Most of these are likely issues that the full game unlocking certain optimization options may have already fixed. Is the game fun? Yes. Can Captain America reflect Iron Man's beam off of his shield? Yes. Can you give the Hulkbuster armor to another hero to fight in? Yes. Can Thor throw Captain America his hammer to fight with? He better be able to. I'd be shocked if Cap wasn't worthy. Shocked, get it? What if Doctor Strange can create portals to send another hero through? Imagine Nightcrawler or Deadpool teleporting in and out of their attacks. Moments like these are what this game will grant players the ability to have. And for many Marvel fans, even after the visual novelty of these repeated animations wear off, the potential for future interactions between fan favorites and newly added heroes might be more than enough for them. Whether you enjoy this game will depend entirely on your preference in games. Sometimes trying to please everyone makes it so that you can't please anybody. If you want more of a single-player game, you have that here. But if you prefer more of an endgame grind for gear, that's here too. The endgame will revolve entirely around repetition of war zones, threat sectors in search of better gear, and resources to level up gear and create ideal loadouts for different situations. And if one mode were the focus, you better believe it's the post-game activities. To make a concise analogy, Call of Duty has Warzone and normal multiplayer. Warzone is currently the primary focus, so normal multiplayer suffers. In the Avengers, postgame is the primary focus, as it should be, as the players who continue to play this game will be the ones keeping it alive. But because of that, campaign suffers. The campaign will be great. Is it as fine-tuned and polished as a Spider-Man or an Arkham game? No. But it's because the co-op-centric modes that are sprinkled in to give people a taste of the post-game are what this game's longevity will really be about. Marvel's Avengers is building a foundation with a lot of potential. If they can consistently roll out new heroes with missions as meaty as what they're including in their initial story campaign, I think many of this game's players will be extremely satisfied. The potential here is strong, and the beta's offered a taste of what, for some, is already the modern upgrade for Marvel Ultimate Alliance that they were looking for. If the performance issues can be resolved, I'll be firmly among the excited fans eager to punish digital bad guys with the inevitable addition of Marvel's finest. Doctor Strange, Scarlet Witch, Black Panther, Vision, Reed Richards, Daredevil. Players have favorites, and this sandbox is already enticing enough to draw out fans whose dream hero isn't even currently in the game. And I'm talking about characters on a team dreamt up over 50 years ago. I'm glad this story begins with the Avengers, because if every single kink is ironed out, this game can easily double the amount sold by the addition of the X-Men. It's crazy to think that as far back as 1963, Marvel told the story of a team of mutants named after Professor Charles Xavier, or Professor X, a man who had a dream of peace and coexistence between mutants and humans. True to real life, many mutants used their powers to cause trouble, and in doing so, made a bad name for the mutants. So Professor X, using his telepathic abilities, tracked and formed a team that would reverse the harm done and show the world mutants were still human. Now, there are a lot of people who I imagine only recently found out that Marvel existed before the movies, and they're patting themselves on the back over Kamala Khan being in the game as a victory, because it's so inclusive. But as a black man, the X-Men's mutants were always thinly veiled representations of minorities and discriminated people. The idea that differences alone were enough to inspire hatred from some people, the lesson that people may convince you that you're a freak or unwanted, only to amplify your insecurities and condition or control you, the exploration of people not actually wanting you for you, but specifically for what you can do for them, these were the kinds of themes explored in X-Men, and Xavier and Magneto's shared vision of peace and equal treatment for mutants, yet their contrasting ideologies about how to go for it,
with Charles being peaceful in his approach and Eric being extremely aggressive. X-Men has always represented the realist side of Marvel for me.
And not grim dark what if Superman attacked us all real, but he's not a hero, he's a freak real. Like if in real life I had powers, I'd show up to 4Pro and I'd stay hidden, lest they show up and dissect me. X-Men brought a bit of that to the table, and the sadness of a mutant desiring to purge what makes them genuinely special because they were convinced by people around them that they are what's abnormal, it's crushing. But the reminder that just because some people consider you less doesn't make it true, that's something that could resonate no matter when you tell that story. Did you know that in 1991, Jim Lee's X-Men issue 1 would go on to become the best-selling comic book of all time, with over 8 million units sold. Storm, Wolverine, Cyclops, Jean Grey, Iceman, Nightcrawler, Rogue, Colossus, Psylocke, Gambit. When any of these characters make it into this game, with their own accompanying mission and their own accompanying villains, and what I'm sure will include the X-Mansion as a social hub, all I can hope is that love, consideration, and understanding of the source material and the era that the comics were written in shine through in whatever narrative Crystal Dynamics crafts. I wish I could be a part of something that I consider so dear to me, as the X-Men are the catalyst for so much of what's dominated television, the movie industry, and now gaming, and has been for decades. To some, this may just be a $60 sandbox that they'll inevitably dump free heroes and games into to charge us for skins and emotes. But if Crystal Dynamics are in this for the long haul and interact with the community, this world could develop and change and have a community as exciting as Warframes. Free roam open spaces with frequently occurring public events, community contests to design banners or skins that make it into the game. By early next year, I'm pretty sure people will know what they're in for when it comes to Marvel's Avengers. Is this game for you? Jump into the free beta and judge for yourself. All I know is I need a PS4 Pro. Thanks for watching.